Hello guys and welcome back to Reborn with Michael Watson, and today we're talking about how to stop trying so hard and how you must stop trying so hard and just trust in the divine. Listen, before I go into this, please do like, share and subscribe, comment below. It really helps the video get to as many people to help them as much as possible. And also join my free Facebook group, The Healing Circle. We're going to be talking about many different things on there. We're helping each other heal. We're helping each other manifest and grow. It's beautiful. So please join there. Link is in the description. Okay, guys. So I've got to get a bit in your face today, because what happens here sometimes with the healing journey and Dr. Joe Dispenza's work, among other people's, is we start to think that we have to follow the formula and we have to do it so much, and we have to be there and elevate my emotions, and I have to sit and meditate for 5 hours a day. And not only then, and I hear this a lot from people who are on healing groups, you know, where they've got this sort of like toxic mentality where it's like, no, dude, you've got to do that meditation at least 4 times a day. It's like, how can you live in the real world and meditate for 4 to 6 hours a day? You're just not going to be living a life. You're going to be living in an idea of a life. And whether you think that is where you need to be or not, I'm just going to let you know that you're trying too hard. You see, you can't add power to the divine. This is the thing that you really need to get your minds around. If you like what I've just said there, comment below. You cannot add power to the divine. The divine is infinite. It takes the divine as much amount of effort to make the grass grow and the rains fall and the sun shine as it does to heal you. There's no effort required. So why do we feel like we have to put so much effort in to heal? And that is because you're frightened, because you're fearful and you're feeling disconnected. You're feeling lackful. And you think if you try harder, it's going to make you more worthy. The truth is you need to start to work on your self-worth, your self-love, and start to speak to yourself and say, what is it I truly need to do? Divine guidance, guide me on the way to this healing journey. And what divine guidance is going to say is going to say, just get into that place. Just follow the process of falling back in love with yourself, falling back in love with life, and letting go of the past. That's as simple as it needs to be. You see, it's that we need to do. We need to surrender to the divine. We don't want to try and force the divine to heal us. We want to just let go to it. And we need to talk about that, because there's a really fine line here. Do we feel like we should be doing nothing, or we should be doing something? Well, my theory is this. Surrender means that I can take a moment to rebalance my thoughts and feelings and lay an intention on it. And then once I've done that, I let go and try to go about my day as joyfully as possible. That's the truth about surrender. It's having an intense trust that you don't need to go any further than you've just gone. When we're not surrendering, we start to put effort in and we start to try. Alan Watts, a wonderful philosopher, said, he called it the law of reverse action. And it's that thing, if you're trying to float, and you're just trying so hard, you inevitably sink. If you're trying to find the love of your life and you're really needy and you're trying so hard to get them to love you, they walk away. What we try so hard for, we seem to push away in life. So what we need to do is start to allow. How do we allow a healing? Well, we start to realize that the body has an inner healing system. If I get a cut, it heals itself. If I go and break my leg and I get it in a splint, it will heal. Do you see what I mean? So think of your meditations, think of your affirmations, think of your self-love as going, I'm just putting a splint on it now, and now the body's going to catch up with me. So we need to sort of slow down a bit, stop trying so hard, and start to just enjoy the process. If you are feeling frightened, I'm going to make more videos on this, on how to overcome the fear. But the main thing you need to do is make all of this just feel a little bit more playful. Make it all feel a little bit more joyful. Okay, so I just needed to tell you all that today. I hope this video really helps you. The thing is, we want it so bad that we get in the energy of lack. So when you're trying so hard, you're actually not overcoming yourself, you're surrendering. So make it about just understanding the process that I need to be the guard of my mind and not let the thoughts come in and the feelings come in that I don't want. And I just need to do my meditations and allow my emotions to come up in a way that feels good. And then I need to let go and surrender to that I've done enough, that I am enough. And then I need to fall in love with myself and in love with life again. That's the simple process here. If this video helped you, please like, share and subscribe and comment down below. Also join my free Facebook group. Thank you so much.